BrazyMikesApps.com with an iPad app video review for Shadowgun Dead Zone. This free multiplayer shooter game will get your adrenaline pumping, has 10 playable characters, various maps, 2 game modes, but is the premium play worth the money? So we checked this game out in early November when we had a beta version of it. I'm going to show you Deathmatch. That's my favorite game mode. Zone Control's all right. I don't like it as much as Deathmatch. Deathmatch, it's every man for himself. Shoot 'em up. You go after everybody. So it is a lot of fun. Get your heart going. Now, the game plays, again, 12 people, up to 12 people, and it's every man for himself. You have a couple of weapons. You can buy other slots. The one thing that Madfinger did that's really good is they didn't make it so you could just go buy money through in-app purchase and buy whatever you want weapon-wise, because then you'd have people running around just killing everybody. You have to actually earn it by playing. The only thing you can buy through in-app purchase is gold, which will give you different players as well as helmets, and that's about it, or skins and helmets. Wear a helmet because it'll save you from a headshot like you just saw. That's what I go for. 100 points a kill, which turns into $100 when it gets down to it. Now, this is what you want. You want a string of kills like this. And this is how you'll become 1, 2, or 3. When you catch guys fighting like that, take advantage of it and kill them both. That's classic. Just don't get caught in the middle of them because then you're sure to die. Again, take advantage. Keep running around. That's my strategy. I don't like sitting still. I lose my helmet, but I take both these guys out, and you get like a 5 or 6 string of kills. Now, we're going to go through, and I have some money, burn a hole in my pocket, so I decide to go up to the Attila. I'm a little bummed out. I think I should have got the Agony, to be honest with you, but whatever. I got the Attila. I'm switching it out. You can see my guns there, big boy. Bandit, not so much into it. And you can upgrade your guns. There's a lot of items, and there's different items for regular gameplay. Now, is the premium account worth it? You got to use gold to get it. I will say that the gold is reasonably priced. That's another good thing that Madfinger did, and there's some free opportunities to get gold. Watching videos, participating, I believe, in some Tapjoy stuff. Now, we're going to get into some wonkiness in a minute. Okay, with premium, 50% more experience, more money earned, and the voice chat. The voice chat is not working. Here's the wonkiness, okay? Sometimes you're going to get a bad connection. I shot that guy like 100 rounds in the head or 30 rounds in the head. I'm headbutting him. I'm trying to kick him. Now, he's not feeling any of that, but I'm taking damage from some other dude. And that's sometimes the way it goes. And this is in premium mode. So they say you get premium connections. I can't throw my grenade. That's pretty much typical. Doesn't happen a lot. When it does happen, it's kind of like you got to take a break and quit the game and then wait a few and then go back on. I don't know if it's overpacked servers or what. Now, these are the kills I didn't show you or my deaths. You will die a lot. You will die a lot. When you level up, you're going to die more because you're going to be playing against people who may have waited and bought some killer weapons. Some of the energy weapons are very deadly. I guess they're under the sniper class. But overall, you're going to die. So just be prepared for it and have a thick skin. Very fun game. It has a decent revenue model. The premium purchase, premium account, you know, it's up to you. I like it, but I'm not going to probably re-up on it. Until next time, see ya.